Welcome to today's Grow It Green. We're at Pawtuckaway Nursery in Lee. I'm joined by Emma Erler from UNH Cooperative Extension. We're talking a little mulch madness here, not to be confused with the mulch. And we have some beautiful mulch right here. But Emma, what are the things I need to look for when I'm going out and buying mulch?
Absolutely. So if you're going to a place like this that sells a lot of different mulches, you might notice that there are lots of different colors of mulch, which, you know, Ray, actually doesn't really matter from a plant's perspective at all. The main purpose of the mulch is to conserve soil moisture, to suppress weeds, and also sometimes we'll add, if you're adding an organic mulch like this, you're actually adding some organic nutrients to the soil.
So in terms of it's all really aesthetics then, we've seen the different colored mulches, you know, here, and obviously there's that dark red that a lot of people use as well.
Of course, yeah. So a lot of that's just up to you. It's up to aesthetics.
Okay. What about now in terms of looking at the mulch itself? What are the things I want to look for? How do I tell a good mulch from bad one?
So a nice bark mulch or wood mulch like this will be broken down a little bit. It'll be aged is generally what they call it. So you don't see any big, huge chips in here. It's pretty fine. And so this will, you know, be a really wonderful material to suppress weeds in the garden.
Now, is it worth going to the spot? I mean, if I'm going to order, like, say, 5 yards just online or something like that, do I really need to go and check it out myself?
You know, I always think it's worth going to the actual place where you're going to buy the mulch just to check out the product and maybe ask any questions if you have them.
Now, speaking of products, it's not just bark mulch you can use. What do we have here?
No, this is actually another product that's made out of compost. This one's called Sweet Pete, but it's a manure and compost-based material, and this can be used as a mulch too. The nice thing about using compost as mulches, as long as they're weed-free, is that you do add more organic matter to the soil.
Now, certainly we've done shows in the past about doing your own composting as well. So is this a time now when you can get all those leaves or whatever and use those as your mulch?
Absolutely, yeah. Shredded leaves from the backyard make a wonderful mulch, as do grass clippings, as long as you haven't treated them with a broadleaf herbicide.
Okay, so one thing you want to look out for, make sure that it's weed-free and the color really doesn't matter. Except for your own aesthetics.
Exactly.
Right? All right, that's it for today's Grow It Green.